The box office numbers are in, and as expected, The Hunger Games: Mockingjay Part 1 dominated the weekend, making roughly double than the next 9 films in the top 10 combined. The new film took in $123 million on its opening weekend, while Big Hero 6 held onto the number 2 spot, making just over $20 million in its third week. Interstellar made another $15 million on its third week, while Dumb and Dumber 2 fell to the number 4 spot, making $13.8 million. Rounding out the top 5 is Gone Girl with its 8th straight week in the top 5, bringing in another $2.8 million. John, what stands out to you about this weekend's box office reports?
A lot of stuff jumps out to me about this. First of all, huge success for Mockingjay. Yeah, it is down from what the opening of the previous two Hunger Games films were. But still a remarkable number. I think somebody actually emailed in last week and said, it might have been during the live Twitter question, somebody said, hey, line at 120 million where Hunger Games make over or under. And we were all like, hey, that's a good number. It was almost dead on of a number. I think we all took over, and it was just slightly over. Huge weekend. You know what? I'm still kind of flabbergasted at the criticism the movie takes. For me personally, I thought it was the best movie of the bunch so far. I thought it was a very different movie from the other ones that we've had in the series so far, but I thought it was very dramatic, really great, slow burn, really good, setting us up for the next one. Wonderful. The drop of Dumb and Dumber 2 also stands out. Dumb and Dumber 2, of course, was ahead of Big Hero 6 and Interstellar last week, dropped below it in the following, I think it dropped like 67%. I think which kind of means that everybody who was really looking forward to this movie were passionate about it, went out to see it right away. And of course, as we're saying week after week after week, Gone Girl. It just keeps hanging in there and hanging around. I think this will probably be its final week in the top 5, but amazing showing for it. Anyway, Dennis, what stands out to you about the box office numbers this week?
Well, it's definitely going to be Mockingjay Part 1. I was one of those people that was like, oh man, it's going to make a ton of money. It's going to make more than the last two, because that's what usually happens, especially when you're coming off a sequel that was well received by both critics and fans.
Yeah.
And so I thought it was going to get closer to, you know, 140, 150 or something like that. And it did not. It's interesting to me. I mean, I know there's a couple of factors. The whole, it's a part one of two thing.
Yeah.
And then also, this is the first one that's like not about the games, and there's less focus on the kind of romantic triangle thing going on. But I still thought it was going to make a lot more.
Really, because I thought that 120 line was... I'm so not used to looking at you on my left. Anyway,
yeah, I know.
Alicia.
I stole your seat. I'm really sorry. I got here first. I'm like, I'm claiming this seat. It's amazing when you look at the difference between number one and number two. I mean, the money that it's made is so huge. Everyone went to see Hunger Games: Mockingjay Part 1 except for me. I haven't seen it yet, and it is killing me right here because I love the book, so I can't wait. I'm going to go see it this week. I love seeing that Gone Girl is still in the top 5. Dennis, I remember when it first came out, you said, and you were totally right, that it would hang on and word of mouth would keep it going, and it definitely has. Dumb and Dumber 2, I haven't seen that film either, but I agree. It seems like everyone went out who wanted to see it, and then everyone else is like, meh. Hunger Games.
Schnapp. Me and Dennis saw it opening weekend, Dumb and Dumber 2.
Same screen, yeah. We didn't even know we were there. We came out of the movie, we saw each other in the parking lot.
And then did the parking lot hang out and chat. Yeah, it was pretty stupid. It was dumb. I loved it. It was so dumb. I also didn't see Hunger Games, and it's bothering me, so I'm glad that you didn't see it.
Yeah.
Just so that we could suffer together. The thing that sticks out to me is that Gone Girl won't be gone. I think it'll stick around. It'll be number 5 next week too, because it is. It's word of mouth, and it's different than everything else that's out there. Mm. So it just it's one of those things where, you know, we were talking about that people show up at the movie theater don't know what they're going to see yet. They're like, I don't know, maybe I heard Gone Girl's good.
Yeah.
Whoop, you know, if like these other ones are selling out, that's usually the second or third one that people are like ratcheting into, as well as just the word of mouth. People want to see it, so.
Although I would love to see Gone Girl Street continue, but what it'll have to go up against, it made 2.something million this week to just barely hang on to number 5, right? So we're still going to have Hunger Games in there. We're still going to have Big Hero 6, which made north of 20.
Right.
We're still going to have Interstellar. And we've got Horrible Bosses 2 coming out, which is going to make more than $2.8 million.
Mm-hmm.
We got The Penguins of Madagascar coming out. So it's going to be a tough thing for Gone Girl to hang on
to
number
five. Let me rephrase that. It'll still be in the top 10, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah. Not top five.
But it's been going for 8 weeks now. That's great. It's crazy.
That hardly ever happens anymore.
Hey everyone, if you like this video, click that thumbs up button and make sure to subscribe to our AMC Movie News YouTube channel. It's free and helps you stay up to date with all the latest movie news, as well as our daily AMC Movie Talk show. Also, make sure that you follow us on Facebook and Twitter to stay up to date with all of our special promotions, contests, and prize giveaways.